Today we would be talking about the poem King Porus, A Legend of Past. King Porus is famous for his war with Alexander. Alexander has been called Alexander the Great because he was a great warrior. And he had come with an only intention to subjugate the whole world. When he came to India, he was defeating many Indian princes. And when he came to Punjab, the Deedian Punjab, now it is part of Pakistan, where the river Jhelum was flowing, he had to fight with King Porus, who was ruling there. Now, there was a famous war between King Porus and Alexander on the banks of the river Jhelum. This war has been described very beautifully by Michael Madhusudan Dutt. He begins his poem like this. Loudly the midnight tempest sang. Now, he talks of war and he talks how things were before war and how things were after war. So he says, loudly the midnight tempest sang. Now, he is talking of a tempest which is singing at the dead of the night, at midnight. It was thy dirge, fair liberty. Dirge means death song. And it was the dirge, the tempest was singing of dirge, of what? Of dirge of fair liberty. It was thy dirge, it was your dirge. Oh fair liberty, oh beautiful liberty. Liberty has been personified. Liberty has been called fair, a beautiful lady. Because when you possess liberty, when you are free, it is almost like you are having a very nice time. And you are enjoying the best of life. But fair liberty is being possessed. It is no more there. It is about to be possessed. The freedom of the country is at stake. And there is, at midnight, we could hear a dirge, which is almost there in the air. And clouds in thundering accents roared. And now see, there is a tempest sank. There is a dirge. And there are thundering accents of clouds which are roaring. They are roaring like a tiger. They are roaring like a lion. Now, all these messages are very ominous. Unheeded warning from on high. Now, these clouds are there high in the sky. They are thundering, but they are unheeded. They are not listened. Unlistened. Warning. They are giving warnings that something ominous would happen, but they are being unheeded, they are not being listened to from on high. They are declaring loud from high, loud from sky, but nobody is there to listen to them. The rain in darksome torrents fell. Now, this is the time of midnight, there is a torrent, there is a sound of dirge, and there are thundering clouds, but there is no one to listen to them. The rain in darksome torrents full. Now there is full rain. They are in torrents. Hydaspes waves did onward sweep. Hydaspes is the river Jhelum. Waves did onward sweep. Now there is almost as if, you know, the river is flowing as if there is a flood and it is sweeping onward with great force, like fiery passion headlong flow. Now, the flowing of the river has been compared to passion. Passion which flows, which is unbridled, which flows headlong. To meet the awakened calling deep. Now, passion is flowing to meet the awakened calling. To meet awakened calling. Now, there is a calling. Passion is always called. it has a call. So it is flowing headlong and it is trying to meet its point of desire, to meet in awakened calling deep. The lightning flashed bright, dazzling light. Now there are lightning, there is a torrent, there is a tempest, there is a river flowing very heavily, there is a dazzling light, and there is a, this light has been compared to, the lightning flashed bright, dazzling like fair women glance from neath a veil. Now this is, since the writer is Indian, the simile is also very, very Indian. The lightning is very bright, and its brightness has been compared to a fair woman, a beautiful woman who is there beneath her veil. And this woman has covered her face, but her face is so bright, she is so beautiful that one could see her sparkling beauty through the veil. And on the heaven troubled air there was a moaning sound of veil, and on the heaving, now the air is also heaving, troubled air is troubled, it is not free flowing air, it is transmitting trouble. There was a moaning sound of wail. Now one could hear a sound of wailing, sound of crying. But in thy unsuspecting sons, now he's saying India's, oh India, thy your unsuspecting sons, your sons who could not suspect, who are too innocent to suspect anything, who are not suspecting any scheming, who are not suspecting any war, or who are not suspecting the actions of an enemy, did heedless slumber. Now this heed word is coming for the second time. And did heedless slumber. They are heedless. They are not listening and they are into slumber. They are into a sleep. While their enemy came in stealthy step of death. Now enemy is coming stealthily, very secretly. Step of death, very silently. The enemy is moving, and it is moving in a step of death. The enemy is bringing death. Came as the tiger, noiseless, slow. Enemy has been compared to a tiger who attacks on its prey, noiseless, very slowly, to close at once its victim's breath. Now it catches the victim and suffocates it in its strangulation or under its jaws and does not let it breathe. So this is how the tiger or the enemy would come and catch the Indian rulers, the Indian princes who are sleeping and who are not listening or who are not careful of the danger which is there. Came in stealthy step of death, came as the tiger, noiseless, slow, to close at once its victim's breath. Alas, they knew not, midst this gloom, this war of elements was burst. Now, the poet says, alas, he is disappointed, and he wants that they should know that this is in between the gloom, this is in between the darkness, the downfall, the war of elements was burst. There are elements of war which are bursting, which are sprouting, which are coming in their direction. Like to an earthquake, again there is a simile in the womb of a volcano. Now, earthquake is in the womb of a volcano. So it is about to burst. It is already there in the womb of the volcano. This danger is already there and it is about to burst. Deep and low, a deadlier storm on them to burst. Now, just as earthquake is deep and low, but it bursts out as a volcano, in the same way, there would be a storm, a deadlier storm, a storm in the form of an enemy which would come and which would burst everything, which would burst the freedom out of you. So we for today, I think, since this is a big poem, for today I think you should try to learn these lines the way I have explained it to you, and then we would move forward with this poem in our next lecture.